Yeah. Good evening. Woo-hoo! So I'm going to go a bit lower than Ben was earlier, starting off talking about his cock. I'm going to start talking about my bottles. So, is any couples in the house?
No.
this advice is going to fall flat then. We're going to talk about post-coital cupping. Anybody heard of that?
Yep.
Not surprised? So for the silent, it's basically after some excessive bedroom acrobatics. You know, you're laid there afterwards, post-coital, nuzzling in, head on the chest, and in the Michael Jackson pose. It's quite nice, speaking from experience. Apart from the one time when my girlfriend kind of shot up like a Labrador in headlights, and she's just like, I found a lump. Now those are the kind of words that any guy doesn't want to hear. But my mind's a bit twisted, so instead of being like panicked and shocked like it should be, I just came back with, well, if you check next to it, I think I find another. So it's a couple of weeks passing, and she's barging me to go to the doctors, and again, like any guy, we just go to the doctors. You know, like her, she'll be in like stub of toe cancer. But yeah, so a couple of weeks, worn down, badges into it, I go, and I get seen, and they're like, all the doctors are busy at the moment, would you like to see a nurse? Now he knows. Because the word nurse comes with a certain mental image. And I was like, yes, I can see a nurse. Unfortunately, when I walked in, also conjures a mental image, is the word matron. And I did what pretty much any guy would do in that situation, which made the following inspection a little tricky. And going in expecting basically my girlfriend, because not to be offensive here, but she was blonde. When we first started going out, she was brunette. You know, I feel like lighter. Her brother called it artificial intelligence. So with the inspection through that, it was actually the bad news, and I was getting a referral. So then at that point, it kind of became serious, and you're like, fuck. Even worse is I'm, as you may have told, British, and we have the NHS, which is fantastic, because it takes you about 9 months to actually see somebody. So when the referral came through in 2 weeks, you're like, shit, this is actually about a bit serious. So I go through on the date, and I get to see the guy, and he gives me the ultrasound. And he holds up what basically looks like a barcode scanner and apologises and is basically like, I may push a little hard because I'm concentrating on the screen, so just let me know if it's a bit too rough. Again, not really the advice you want. And so he puts on a liberal amount of lube. So this is actually where the story gets a bit not too bad, if you can kind of distance yourself from the whole situation. It wasn't actually that, you know, traumatic to go through as an experience. And you, I don't know if you bothered to know, but I got the all clear, so they're still here. Woo! Still mine. And I guess the moral of the story is just don't put these things off, because she'll just wait in your ear for months of it. And it's probably nothing. So anyway, that's close enough.
Yeah.